Everyone knows the National Rifle Association is super powerful, but how'd it get that way? Here's a brief history. The NRA was founded in 1871 by Civil War veterans concerned that their fellow Yankees had forgotten how to shoot. They started the NRA to fix that. The whole idea was to promote rifle practice. Over the next few decades, the NRA waded, gently, into politics. In the 1930s, for instance, when gangsters with Tommy guns were all over the news, Congress debated a bill called the Firearms Act, which is widely known as the first real gun control bill. The NRA opposed it, lobbying Congress to take out any mention of pistols and revolvers, but they were willing to live with regulations on submachine guns and sawed-off shotguns. So, by today's standards, pretty tame. Let's fast forward to the 1960s. We had the civil rights movement, urban riots, students protesting the Vietnam War, rising crime rates, and a number of high-profile assassinations, from JFK to MLK Jr. To many in mainstream America, there was just this feeling that violence was overtaking society. So in 1968, when the Black Panthers began to carry guns as an act of civil disobedience, it was a bridge too far for middle class, especially white Americans. Lawmakers across the country, liberals and conservatives alike, began pushing for gun control laws. The Republican Party's national platform even supported gun control on tough-on-crime grounds. And in California, Governor Ronald Reagan led the gun control charge. But the reaction was swift. Gun owners, especially rural conservatives, already alienated by rapid cultural shifts, began to worry. Was the government coming for their guns next? So they began mobilizing, lobbying, and joining the NRA. Between 1964 and 1980, NRA membership tripled from 600,000 to nearly 2 million, and its coffers exploded with new dues. For the NRA's old guard, who still thought of the NRA as a shooting club, it was a weird time. In 1977, new NRA members ousted the old board and replaced them with new and much more political leadership. From there on out, the NRA was extremely hardline about opposing all gun control.
I am against the kind of gun control that is being talked in the Congress of the United States. I see it as only something that would make it difficult for an honest citizen to own a gun, but would do nothing at all to impede the criminal in his getting a gun.
And in 1980, it endorsed its first presidential candidate, Ronald Reagan. In the 1990s, two gun control laws were passed, but they were relatively limited in scope and built to expire.
Since the Brady Bill passed, 250,000 felons, fugitives, and mentally unstable persons had been stopped from purchasing handguns.
And then, in the early 2000s, the NRA really began to hit its stride.
From my cold, dead hands.
It rolled out its grading system, issuing A-pluses to politicians most in line with its vision, and Fs to those in favor of gun control. Voters take that system seriously. The right grade makes or breaks a politician's career. A few years later, in 2008, it won a huge Supreme Court case, finding that the Second Amendment guaranteed private individuals, and not just a well-regulated militia, a constitutional right to own guns. In 2016, the NRA spent $419 million on political campaigns, and more than $30 million on Donald Trump alone.
There's no bigger fan of the Second Amendment than me, and there's no bigger fan of the NRA.
It also endorsed Trump earlier than it had endorsed any presidential contender ever.
I'm officially announcing the NRA's endorsement of Donald Trump for president.
Today, the NRA is, by nearly any measure, at the top of its political power. But it's also facing a brand new challenge, furious teenagers.
To every politician who is taking donations from the NRA, shame on you.
In the name of 17 people, you cannot ask the NRA to keep their money out of your campaign.
After the mass shooting in Parkland, Florida, young people have been staging walkouts, planning protests, and demanding exactly the kind of gun control the NRA has spent the last 50 years fighting. And while many of these students can't even vote yet, in a few years, the NRA may have more to worry about at the polls.
We will accept nothing less than comprehensive gun control. And if it's what it takes, we will shame our national policymakers into protecting us.